finally got camp all set up. The Shangri-La of the bush. Definitely didn't need to set up a camp like this, but you know what? Comforts make you hunt longer sometimes, so hopefully that helps a little bit. We're in the same spot that we were in October when it was really hot. I'm hoping now that there's been a shift in the weather, there's a little more activity and start seeing more. And you know, now there's a bit of snow up top, so I should be able to see some tracks up in there. But yeah, I'm excited. I think it's time to get out hunting. Let's do it. So a deer driving in to this slash. I got a pretty good feeling about just this week. I'm tucked in this nice little hole with this rock beside me sheltering me from the wind. This ridge that's above had a bunch of beds on it, so this is right where I saw that deer the last time. I mean, it's just a nice spot. I can see deer coming off of that ridge and down into this area, down into this opening.
So skittish. I think he was like that because of the wind. I don't think it was me. At this point, I've got 2 days left for any buck, but he was super skittish. It sucks because he never stopped. He like stopped once, ate, and then he was like, he was on edge. Well, I was just driving in, saw 8 does coming in, and then I was walking. Walking along the timber line here, and I'm coming up, and I just see three deer darting. So, yeah, there's a lot more activity. Just glassing across this bowl right now. It's about 800 yards across. I'm kind of getting the vantage points, glassing a bit, and moving, glassing a bit. Basically just trying to get different views of the bowl, because there's different, like there's a bunch of little folds that you can't see from like one spot to the next, so I'm just trying to up my odds that way. A moose came through here. As the day dwindles on, I plan on moving down lower to try my odds there.
I'm on like cloud nine right now because I've just been hunting so hard. Like so hard. Like this year. And to still hunt a whitetail like this. Man. It's just insane. So I wrapped up onto the ridge, and I was coming up onto the ridge, and the wind was blowing up the ridge. I came down off of the ridge towards this aspen thicket, and I found a rub, a decent
looked at the hair on the robin, it looked really light. It looked like a whitetail. And I was like, whoa, that's pretty cool. But it was an old rub. But I didn't really think much of it. You know, sure enough, I'm still hunting through this. I cannot believe I still hunted this guy. I mean, how else are you gonna do it unless you know where they are, right? I knew it was a whitetail zone, but I didn't think that this guy would be here. This is a big whitetail, and he's mature, and he's been living in here for a while. Nice. It's time to get to work. Well, now that the nerves have settled a little bit, everything went perfectly tonight. If it didn't, I wouldn't have seen him. It was like the perfect scenario. Went up on the ridge, wind was pushing up on the ridge, and then dropped down the ridge straight towards the aspen thicket. All the wind was pushing up towards me. I still hunted through. I bumped a doe, muley doe, which was so weird. Bumped the muley doe. And then kept still hunting. Then about 300 yards after, was staring directly at this guy's face looking at me 30 yards away. Loaded one slowly. I was like, I'm not bringing up the camera. Like, the camera's not coming out. It kind of sucks that I didn't get it on video, but I was not letting this guy pass. He's a great buck. What an awesome animal.